Wilshire members and their friends are part of the Wilshire Wind Symphony, and they play once a month in worship on Sunday morning. They are conducted by the wonderful Shana Gaines, and we're so grateful for all of your hard work in getting ready for this evening. And we are so happy also to welcome the magnificent Laurice Lanier to be our guest soloist tonight. She sang in worship this morning, and you're going to want to go YouTube that one, believe me. In any case, let's feel the Spirit.
Being here tonight. And right now, I want to ask you if you are a veteran on active duty or a member of the armed forces, or you're a family member of someone who served, if you would please stand when you hear a song from your branch of the military represented. We'd be delighted to thank you and recognize you this time.
Army.
Oscar. Navy. Thank you. As we celebrate our American freedom, we'd be remiss if we didn't acknowledge that part of our history is fraught with maltreatment of various people groups. The state of slavery is a chapter of our history we cannot forget and that we need to learn from. But one gift that we've received from this chapter is the religious folk songs from African slaves who were introduced to Christianity in America. The spiritual. Spirituals have their roots in African culture, where music is a central part of everyday life. However, Africans were also forced to sing, both on slave ships and on land. The slaves used spirituals to call informal secret meetings, communicate coded messages, and yes, even to express their newfound faith. Swing Low, Sweet Chariot is thought to be one of these coded messages, with the Sweet Chariot perhaps being the Underground Railroad. And coming for to carry me home meant take me to freedom in the North. The band of angels would be those workers on the Underground Railroad. The spiritual is said to be a favorite of Harriet Tubman, and this arrangement communicates the longing as well as a message of hope.
Thank you.
As you might imagine, spirituals are not always viewed as art music. The great composer Antonin Dvorak sojourned in America and studied folk music and hymnody here. He remarked that the Negro spiritual was the only genuine folk music in America that could be developed into a characteristic American style. Feel the Spirit is an art song cycle of spirituals arranged by John Rutter, a prolific English composer of church music. Originally composed for orchestra, choir, and mezzo-soprano solo, we are pleased to present selections from this arrangement for symphonic winds and mezzo-soprano solo tonight as set by Paul Noble. We'd like to thank Jeff Brummel for his collaboration with us on this as well.
Thank you. Sometimes I
last song from that cycle has become synonymous with New Orleans culture and jazz. Our next number also has a close association with New Orleans, and this swing arrangement is more of a dance than a walk. I'm happy to feature some of our talented players for this one. Mark McKenzie on alto saxophone, Luke Wingfield on trumpet, and the stylings of George Gagliardi on piano.
Thank you.
Okay, so I first met our soloist, Laurice Lanier, after my junior year of high school. And we were both selected to be part of Tennessee Governor School for the Arts. So the rest of us were singing, you know, 24 Italian songs and arias and all the typical things you expect. And then I heard Laurice stand up and sing this duet with another girl at Governor School, Order My Steps. I'd never heard anything like it. I'd never heard a voice like it at that time. So I was fortunate enough again to hear her in All-State Choir and again as a college student, because I went to college in Jackson and that's her hometown. So when I started thinking of what I wanted to do for this year's concert, I couldn't think of any other voice but hers to sing with us tonight. So watching her career blossom over the years has been great fun for me. I'm so excited to be able to share her with you. Once again, Laurice Lanier.
Had a blessed day here, and I love you all. It is so beautiful to be here, and I'm just so blessed to share the stage with this wonderful, wonderful Winds Ensemble. I pray that you are blessed by these spirituals, this little light of mine.
Woods and the waters in his hand. He
Jesus, give
Laurice, thank you so much for your gift of music tonight and Wilshire Wind Symphony as well. We're so glad that all of you have been here tonight. As a reminder, after the last song, you're invited downstairs below here to Community Hall for some pie and coffee. We hope you'll join us there. The Wind Band, or Wind Symphony, as we call it now, is a quintessential American symbol of freedom and of community. If you think about the marching band down Main Street in the small town on the 4th of July, or the community band playing in the town square, sort of a Norman Rockwell ideal. One of the reasons that the Wind Band has been so much a part of our American history is because it's portable. It's hard to carry a violin, or a piano, or an organ. But these instruments all carry. They're transportable. And guess what? You have an instrument too. It's your voice. And it's also portable. We hope that as you leave here tonight, you will carry a song of freedom in your heart. A song that you may sing or you may speak wherever you go, because you too, each of us, has a song to sing that God has given to us. And just as the band marches down the street in the parade or gathers in the town square, so we too may be part of that wonderful song as we carry the news of freedom.